You're watching Mystery School, the first late night show on the net, with your hosts, Owen Bones and Tony B. Jr. Let's begin.
Oh, yeah.
You see how I made a walk-in entrance like that?
What's up?
What's up? What's up? Hey, everybody over there looking good, yeah. Smelling like baked macaroni, man. Fucking craziness.
All right.
Crazy.
Welcome back, everyone. It's the Mystery School stream on a Friday. Last stream of the week. Can we please have some Mystery School Union emotes in the chat? It's me. It's vaguely more inebriated than usual on the stream.
And, it's a me.
Tony Reed Jr. here to do the show.
The usual amount of inebriated that I always am, so.
And it's
nothing,
time.
Nothing new here.
Yep. Sure is time to start doing the Mystery School stream. Let's fucking go.
That's right. That's right, y'all. Let's get ready. We got some great news lined up for y'all tonight, man. A bunch of cool shit has happened. But before we get into that stuff, what do you think about taking some letters from our wonderful class?
Let's go, dude. We got some great letters tonight and some absolutely fucking deranged ones, as usual. So let's start out somewhere in the middle. This question is actually very reasonable. Anonymous asks, can we come up with a hive name for Mystery School? You know, something like the Barbs, Navy, Bay Hive. Can we be the MM Sus Union? Chat, do you have any ideas for the Mystery School Union name? I feel like the Mystery School Union is kind of the name, but we're open for an official rebrand. So just let them rip in the chat real quick.
We'll see. That's all. We'll see about that. That doesn't sound bad. I do like the Union one that we had. We'll see if somebody comes up with something better. But I think that's a good idea. We should have an official name.
Blaine Jameson says topless male.
What was that about?
The person got his nipple sucked on Zoom and was identified only as a topless male.
Nameless naked bastard. You didn't even get fucking labeled.
Stupid idiot.
Random topless asshole got his nipple sucked on Zoom.
The who is that? The gummy mimes. The sussies.
The sussies. I like the sussies.
The blood hurt men.
Wait, that alienates everyone whose blood doesn't hurt, though, so I don't know if we could do that.
Mystery Students Union, suggests Weast. Mystery Valedictorian. H-Rollies.
What are the New Boys fans called? Those are New Boysians?
No, those are the Noobs.
Oh, okay.
All right, well, help us figure this out in the Discord. We didn't see a name that jumped out at us there. Thank you, Anonymous, very much for your question. We will get on this, I promise you.
Yeah, we'll keep considering that as we go down the line.
Oh, actually, sorry, I misspoke. The New Boys fans are called the Jerkers, apparently.
Oh, okay.
Wait, I thought that was Kelly Swag District did Teach Me How to Jerk. I always confuse these
teach
guys.
Teach me how to jerk? Teach me how to jerk? Remember that Schoolboy Q line?
Teach me how to jerk?
Teach me how to jerk? I don't even know what that was in reference to, but I loved it.
He just really wanted you to teach him. All right, anyway, you have a letter here?
Sure, this one is good. This is from our friend Jerry Cho. He asked, if you could be a professional at any sport, which one would it be?
God.
I like that one because lo and behold, there are so many sports in the world, y'all, that you don't even consider or know about or watch on TV. I am a fan of a sport called curling, where
you
slide some smooth bullshit rock against the ice, and then it just glides slowly down the lane until somebody wins points for something. I don't even know the rules, but I just see them shoveling a bunch of snow real fast like this and scraping the ground. And I always wanted to do that, man. So if I could be a professional, I'd be a professional curler.
I don't know
how much they get paid, but
shout out curling.
It's worth it.
Was this close to being called edging? Anyway, I would like to be a professional ping pong player because the pro ping pong players are fucking like monstrous in their physical and athletic ability. And it's something casual enough that you can casually crush the shit out of just like a normal person at a barcade and demonstrate your ludicrous talent as well. So I would like to be good at ping pong.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of games that I could take out on like normal drunk people at bars and they don't know you're a professional at it before you play.
That's always the best. Also, you remember when Rockstar, creator of Grand Theft Auto and other acclaimed series, made that table tennis game?
Oh, yeah. That was crazy.
Crazy. Shout out Rockstar. I fuck with that. Bring it back. All right. Damn. I got another question here from Anonymous. This one is a bit more long form. I was in the car, Anonymous says, I was in the car with my mom and I had to connect to the Bluetooth so we can hear the GPS on my phone, and the last song I was playing was off the Sudden Death mixtape. So all it said on screen was Brian Pumper type beat, and my mom instantly got mad and said, get this off of there, ew, I don't want to see that name, and I laughed it off, but now I'm wondering, how in the hell does she know about the OG troll Brian Pumper? So, to be clear here, our question from Anonymous is, why does my mom know who Brian Pumper is?
A good question, and, mom?
I mean,
any answers?
You know, I mean, he's a very acclaimed public figure, you know? His renown is widespread and girthy.
Wow, yeah, I never thought of Brian Pumper's he is in a generation of where you know, older people were watching a lot of his films, and we got a fucking gift bonanza by House Graphics.
House
right
Graphics.
Here. Thank you, man.
10 gifted subs. Thank you so much, dude. Really appreciate that. House Graphics, welcome back. The
we
god.
Love you, man.
Welcome back,
well,
dude.
Well, that edges us a little bit closer to tonight's sub goal. If we want to unlock that sudden death, y'all know how to do it, man. Hit that sub goal. Let's get another quick one. Before we get into the news, I had a cool one right here. Let's see, where did it go? Oh, this one is from Kango.
Okay.
It just says, I always play with my Woochie Pit while watching the stream.
Kango, thank you.
Good.
Thanks. Good. And good.
Make sure you do baby powder to back of that, though, man. Yeah. Just so you don't get any infections.
Chat, if you don't know what the Woochie Pit is, it's the back of your knee.
Mm-hmm. So the wet, soft part back behind your knee. It's kind of like an armpit, but for your knees.
All right.
Woochie Pit is what that's called.
All right. One last question here from Anonymous. Anonymous simply asks, who's squirting? Can we please have a one in the chat if you are presently squirting? And with that note, let's do the news. What do you say, man?
Yeah, it's about that time. We've lost our integrity already.
We got lots of ones in the chat. Make sure to put down a tarp or something because the smell does not come out of furniture. House Graphics, thank you again for the 10 gifted subs. And chat, remember, if we hit our gifted sub goal up here tonight, we will do Sudden Death. The segment where we make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you get to pick the topic based off of all the news articles that we cover tonight. That's how I imagine Future looks when he's making these songs. Just kind of like... Yeah, you know. So anyway, on that note, it's time for the news. Let's start with some drip news. That's right, everyone. Adidas and M&M's shoes.
All right. Yo.
Except for this one that's off the rip, shit colored.
This dookie colored. Oh, red color, yellow color. Off the rip, y'all. These. I'm getting a vibe for them. I'm seeing what's happening and what the purpose of these would be for. Anybody in the chat, you probably have to be born in the 90s somehow. I don't think 2000s kids will know about this type of person, but there's a type of person that used to wear what we call like NASCAR racing jackets.
Dude, all right? Multiple people in the chat all said that at the same time.
Yeah. Oh, Bob Eggs, you know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
All right, so there's NASCAR racing jacket guys from my childhood, man. Usually fight a lot, got good hands on them.
They fight a lot.
Might not be in school all the time.
Right.
They come to school sometimes, and maybe they might be smelling like a little weed coming into high school sometimes. But they usually were pretty funny at lunch, you know, NASCAR racing jacket kids. And I think that these shoes are like the natural evolution to the racing jacket. I think these will be like a Gen Z version of that kid. So the kids that are coming to school maybe 2 days a week with a black and mild in their hand and maybe fighting at lunchtime.
Right.
They definitely have these M&M Adidas, man.
Yeah, dude,
I think this is the evolution.
I mean, black and mild fighting at lunch kid in high school, I feel like is eternal. You know, they probably have updated their arsenal a little bit, like the sort of recreational drugs that they're doing and the fit and the amount of nicotine in their body on account of juuling. But outside of that, it's eternal, man. That those kids live forever and they always need an outfit. So why not, you know, match the M&M's shoes with the Cookie Monster fitted in and just let chaos reign?
Well, Honestly, the Cookie Monster fitted archetype and the Eminem jacket arc, those are two, they're actually polar opposites on the spectrum.
They would probably honestly get into racial confrontations, all things
those
considered.
Are
so.
Both equally chaotic, but really different spectrums of the violence right there.
Yeah, similar violence, different locales. Yeah. Also, the Eminems have such a horny backstory. All the M&Ms are fucking each other now. Is that like a modern development? Oh shit, Anthony. Damn.
Anthony with the five.
Thank you for the five gifted.
Finball right there. We might hit this sudden death tonight, y'all. Thank you for all the gifts. Anthony, we appreciate it.
Thank you so much for the five, man. Grishmapolitan. I don't know why I'm struggling with your name so much. I'm really sorry. Yo, I'm a high school teacher. I gotta say, kids struggling with attendance are just wearing the sneakers, selling out on the sneakers app. LOL. I mean, yeah, that's okay. That sounds about right as well.
That's one type of kid missing school for sure. Got the sneakers app shoes for sure.
So can anyone confirm or deny if the M&Ms are have a horny backstory now? I'm gonna Google search lesbian M&M.
The green one is the horniest M&M I've ever seen in my life.
Oh yeah,
the
green one and the brown one are going out. Oh, I should have checked to make sure safe search was on before I hit this. Hold on.
Oh, yeah, you're going to run into some real M&M sex,
M&M
man.
M&M deviant art shit.
Some real candy-coated juices.
So these two M&Ms are together. I'm very happy for them.
They are cute.
This
as
one
fuck.
Reminds me of Bayonetta.
She definitely got a Bayonetta vibe, man. But the green M&M, I always felt such a sexual tension coming from her since she came into the picture in 93, that. Man. I mean, I was like, damn, I fucked that M&M.
Green M&M knows exactly what she's working with, and I'm happy for her to settle down in a monogamous relationship. So, yeah. Green M&M, good on you.
I'm happy for them, man. The rest of the M&Ms, though, look like they just are struggling singles and never going to get anybody. So,
green's got some. Also, check this out. The green M&M... kind of glowed up, honestly.
Wow.
Shit.
Yeah, they made a big change right there. Shout out to Green M&M getting whatever procedure she needed done, man. If she wanted to change how she looked, I think that's fine,
she
man.
Because Dr. Miami and, come out looking different, it's okay.
That's maybe the M stands for Miami, man. Maybe it ain't all about the M&Ms.
I thought it was the brown one. I am kind of colorblind.
No, that's more of a doo-doo green, but it's still green.
Yes. So shout out to the M&Ms. Their incredibly sexually charged backstory. And I guess those Adidas, our chat didn't immediately get very offended, and we didn't start, cringing and shit, which is usually a pretty good sign for the fashion things we talk about on the stream, all things considered.
No, those shoes, I just, TT the Ginger, thank you for that five piece right there.
TT the Ginger! It's their first time gifting subs in the channel as well. TT the Ginger, thank you so much for deciding to gift us five subs in this year stream. We appreciate that. We're moving ever closer to tonight's Sudden Death unlock. With TT the Ginger's contributions, we are over a quarter of the way there. Sudden Death is looking very possible. If you want to see us make a full song live in under 30 minutes, let's hit the goal. And that will also mean a miniature streak has started. Since Sudden Death is guaranteed on Monday, this will guarantee four Sudden Deaths in a row if we hit it tonight. So
would
we'll
you
see.
Look at that, man?
We'll see what happens.
Oh, I keep burping. I am so sorry.
Young General So, thank you for the gift of sub, man.
General So.
Appreciate that. All right. Who remember the sexy Latin orange Cecil from Sesame Street? Asked Lil Uzi Vert. Excuse me?
Boy, what?
Depot Jankles. Thank you for the gifted sub. Laker fan, thank you for the gifted sub. Wow, gifted subs raining down. On our heads. Hold on, I need to Google that.
Come on, man. I'm having a little stroke. Wait, the Latin
Cecile?
Orange? The Latin orange Cecil from Sesame Street.
Okay, I just... What? Oh, dude. Lil Uzi Convertible is a different type of horny today.
Because, oh, you on demon time, bro. I don't want to see this.
This is the only thing the Google image results returned.
I remember that shit! Wow.
Damn, bro.
Did look good, though. I used to definitely want to fuck that, too.
Yo, you're horny for just an orange circle with some lips.
But hear me out, bro. Wait till she started talking, man. Once she started moving them things.
Okay, hold
on. If you were 5 years old alone, man, you would probably do the same
thing.
Okay,
hold up. I'll pull up a clip here. Sesame Street.
Dog, I'm talking throat. She used to be like, I'm just going to count to 13. Do you know how to count to 13, little man?
Okay.
I was like, hell yeah, I know how to count to 13. I'm five. Bitch.
Okay, how about
count
this
13
here.
Right now?
She can bounce, she can roll, she can spin like a wheel. She's got a rubber soul and
wow.
Cecile, no one can match ya. Cecilia.
Wow. Damn, she turned into a fleshlight too. You see that?
I mean, she does kind of have a dominant presence, you know?
She got that.
So, I'm sorry I can't be her. Sorry, folks.
Damn, she could have all my tea.
All right. Let me see if I can find another clip here of just her talking. Because, this one's called I'm Gonna... What the fuck?
Y'all risking it all for old Cecilia or what? Ooh.
Damn, I mean, she does kind of have a voice.
Oh, look at her turning into the heart-shaped ass.
Damn, I mean,
damn, baby.
Wow.
You about to get peeled in here, shorty.
All right, well, I kind of, you know, while I initially casted some judgment for being turned on by just a circle, an orange circle with lips, you know, I got to say, I see where you all are coming from, and I respect Cecile on Sesame Street.
Yeah, no kink shaming here, man. If you want to fuck that clay orange, then more power to you, man. Long as it's consensual. Wait, you...
Anyway, all right. Okay. All right. All right. Where were we? Anyway, actually, fitting segue here. Fitting segue. Oh, I'm getting a little dizzy. Okay, 30 subs, the way to sudden death. Nasty rum style, says Steve Tay.
Nasty rum style.
Do we have the viewer who posted about their nasty rum style exploits in the gambling section of the Discord today?
Oh, D. White, thank you for those 100 bits, my
D.
man.
White, appreciate that. Laker fan, Debo Dangles, Young General So, thank you for the gifted subs. TT the Ginger, Anthony with 5, and House Graphics with 10. We appreciate you all very much. We are on the way to sudden death tonight. Who off the nasty rum.
That's what it is. Yeah, man. Well, what do you say about a gamble, man? Should we jump into one of those?
Let's do it.
Let's do
last
that.
Last thing I do need to say is DK Yamat says, if I was stuck on a stranded island with her, let's just say I wouldn't have to worry about scurvy.
Oh, you got vitamin C out the ass, huh, big man?
All right, yeah, let's gamble.
Big man.
Let's gamble. You know, I do want to draw attention
Hit that Discord gamble section
exactly,
again, man.
Exactly, dude. To the gambling section of the Discord. There was some shit in here today. Unique suggests one take article. Will I be able to read an article without any errors, without any reading errors? And then Nick Savage said, I want to believe it, but Owen can't read that well. LOL.
Can't read that well.
Wow. All right.
You gonna assault this man's literacy like that in front of all these people?
I mean...
Yeah, my boy do be mispronouncing a Slovakian name here and there, but like,
damn,
it's just because he hasn't been there, man, you know?
Wow, that Nick, you know, true to your name, that was savage, all things considered.
Wow.
So, you know what? I think we should run that one at some point tonight. Mm-hmm. Then
I'm liking that.
Unique did come in to defend me having an entire debate career in which I also won first speaker at the Urban National Debate Tournament in 2012, but that's neither here nor there, so you know, we'll see. Professor Colby, thank you for the 5 gifted. We appreciate that.
I saw that. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Talk to him, Owen, says Kanko. Let's go. Talk to him. Thank you, Professor Colby, for the 5 gifted and for the bits earlier. Thank you very much. We do have some other really good bets in here, such as, will the chat be mad? I mean, that one's easy.
Ah, yes. I can guarantee that one.
Will there be tattoos?
Oh, I forgot about tattoos.
Ads only bet. I do like the chaotic ads only idea. Will they mention crypto? That's a good one there, too.
Okay, let's start with an ads only bet for sure.
Okay, what are you thinking?
Let's do 3 articles. Ads only.
Okay.
Since they're ads, I think we can get a little bit more wild with those because anything could happen in an ad, you know.
All right.
Next 3 articles, ads only.
Dude, we can just rip that one, the crypto one, honestly.
What was it about the crypto?
Will we see
anything crypto related?
Crypto.
Let's run it. It's ads, so they could be there. Let's run that one.
All right.
First bet of the night, guys. Let's get it going.
Next 3 articles, will there be a mention of crypto? Ads only. Also, it's time for one of our call-ins here on the Mystery School stream. It's Dad Tay's birthday. Let's get him in here, man. Go ahead, unmute yourself. We're going to pull you into the green room.
Let's talk.
We're talking to Dad Tay tonight. Can the mods hold off on awarding the bets too early today, asks Jerry Cho. Dude, honestly, I gotta say, while I do defend the mods, it feels good to not have threats aimed towards you and I specifically on the stream for the gambling. So,
yeah, I got a family, man. I couldn't take those type of threats and insults.
Jesus. All right. Here we go. I'm pulling Dad T in here.
I don't have a family.
Dad Tay.
Dad.
You're live on the stream,
man.
How are you doing?
How are you? I am excellent. How are you?
Doing great, man. It's your birthday today.
Mm-hmm.
Happy birthday!
Happy B-Day.
Yeah,
let's
man.
Go.
Can we get a happy birthday, Dad Tay, in the chat, please? How old are you today, dude?
I appreciate that. Today, I am 34.
Dude, congratulations.
One step closer to 40.
Yes.
Nah, if you're 34, you're 44, man. We already discussed this. Congrats on making it to be alive this long, man. You've been through several different centuries, damn near. You saw the 1900s. You saw the early 2000s. You lived through housing crisis. You lived through the Gulf War. You fucking lived through Martin and Fresh Prince, bro. How do you feel about being so goddamn old?
I feel like a learned doctor for real, man. Like, absorbing all of this knowledge and energy is perfect.
Absolutely,
damn,
dude.
That's fire. Well, dude, that's fire.
I gotta say, you've spent at least a portion of your waking life in the Mystery School stream here with us, and we really appreciate that, man. Thank you for all your generosity and just hanging out with us in the Discord and in the chat and shit. Is there anything on your birthday you would like to say to us or to the viewers?
Hell yeah, man. It's funny because I feel like... I never really cared about online communities and shit like that before, but this was like one of the coolest things that I've gotten into in the past year, man. And I've like really enjoyed myself getting to know everybody that hangs out in the community and contributing to the laughs and just having a good time. And it's nice to have something to fall back on as an adult, you know, when you're having a hard day or whatever, man, life is just getting you down, to go into the Discord and to be able to shitpost, talk about some serious shit, whatever it is, man. Just to be able to have a place where I can feel like myself and be received positively. It's an unreal feeling, man. And you know, when you get older, you don't be meeting people and making friends as much as you used to. At least that was my experience. So
Dad,
it's nice.
I not to cut you off, but I was about to say the same thing. As we get older, we don't have friends anymore, man.
Bro,
our friends,
you know it, man.
Our friends are fucking gone. They don't like us anymore. They don't like
right,
fun.
Dude.
They don't like fun shit. At least they're like, dude, no, I don't want to fucking watch it. I can't hang out. I can't fucking play. They don't do anything fun. So as you get older, you lose all of your friends. And
dude, you are not lying. You're not bullshitting.
I'm not bullshitting. If you got a place to come to where it's just a cool vibe, man, I really suggest to go to a place like that, man.
So, on my birthday, I want you guys to know that I did a lot of good this last year, man. I got my career back on path. My wife just got her master's. Our daughter is healthy and super intelligent. But Mystery School is like third or fourth down on the list of really things I'm proud to be a part of, man. Like, all the homies in the chat, everybody, Drowsy, Markov, House,
let's go.
Harry, Aggie, all of the regulars, man, Kango, all of them, Kicks, everybody's cool as fuck, and I enjoy myself on a day-to-day basis, man, and I try to get everybody that I know hooked on this shit because it's gonna blow. I'm proud of you guys. I'm happy to be associated with you guys. You're both hyper and so incredibly talented, man, and just thank you.
Dude, hey, man, thank you, man. We appreciate it. I couldn't even follow up such... genuine words, man. We appreciate
you,
bro.
Thank you so much, dude.
And happy birthday
again,
man.
Happy birthday. Can we get one more round of happy birthdays for Dad Tay?
Let me get off this birthday soapbox, all this emotional stuff. Let's get back to the gas leak, bro.
One last thing. Do you have a birthday wish that you think that we might be able to fulfill on the stream today? We might be able to make something happen.
I got a birthday wish that my wife can probably fulfill, and she's somewhere in the chat, somewhere in the house.
Oh, let's go.
Oh, let's go.
Fair enough. Dante, dude, we love you, man. Thank you so much for your kind words.
Yes,
thank you for fucking with
it.
The Mystery School stream, dude. I'm sure we will talk to you soon.
Always,
hey,
man.
Peace out, man. Let's peace. Go.
Peace out, dude. Yes, the vibes are good on
that's
tonight's
it.
Friday stream. I had a good feeling about this stream, chat. I had a good
that's
feeling.
Great.
Happy birthday, Dante. Thank you for being here. Thank you for the kind words, man.
All right. Yeah. Well,
now, back to the degeneracy. We wasted too much time being kind to one another, talking amongst ourselves, and now it's time for the
rat fuck prison planet
that we all inhabit. Let's roll right into this this next article, man. What do you say?
Let's do it, man.
All right. We got an update we haven't really talked much about on the stream, but Twitch launches category dedicated to hot tubs after rejection from advertisers. Ooh, there's a good chance for crypto ad here. So, if you don't know, there was kind of a shift in a lot of the most popular channels on Twitch. The channels consistently raking in the highest viewerships and also growing the quickest were hot girls in skimpy bathing suits, either at the pool or inside of an inflatable pool inside of their own house. And a lot of people were really mad about this, primarily because they just hate women, which is, you know, not a good argument to have.
Not a good look,
not
buddy.
A good look at all. But it did raise some issues, because while we could talk, we could do an entire stream talking about what sort of shit is supposed to be on streaming services, break down the morality of it, blah, 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 all that shit. No one really cares. The only thing that this really affected was advertising on the platform. You don't have to look at this. If you hate to look at beautiful women on the internet, then I guess you can just close your eyes and go somewhere else. But it did cause advertisers to pull out, and it also caused some discussion about what should be allowed on Twitch, because it wasn't TOS. It was very right. horny. It was extremely erotic, but it was not TOS at all.
By the book.
So this was Twitch's response today. We're not going to spend too much time talking about this. We can talk more about it in the Discord if you want, because I'm sure a lot of people have opinions on this. We just wanted to deliver the news here that Twitch is launching a dedicated category for hot tub streams after stating it has received pushback from advertisers and viewers on how the trend has taken over the platform. The new pools, jacuzzis, and beaches category is intended to allow creators to stream whatever they want, while also giving Twitch advertisers a more convenient way to prevent ads from running on streams they don't approve of. Earlier this week, Twitch removed advertisements from some hot tub streamers without notice. In a statement sent to The Edge today, the company said it was a mistake. We did not alert affected creators at the time, and we should have. Our creators trust us, a spokesperson said. Twitch said the ads were suspended at the request of advertisers and that it is now working with individual creators to restore the ads when appropriate. In particular, the ad suspension affected Amaranth, who actually follows the Mystery School stream. Shout out to her. Who is one of the biggest streamers on the platform. Your channel is showing ads again, although it appears that your hot tub news has been removed. So, people were really mad about this. I don't know how many of our viewers like spend a shitload of time on Twitch outside of watching the Mystery School stream. But if you were like a diehard Twitch viewer, so many people were mad about hot tub streamers, which I just don't get it, man. I don't get how you could be upset about that.
It's just one of those battles that have been going on since the dawn of Twitch. You get a lot of I hate to say it, but you get a lot of angry kind of like basement dweller guys that are maybe streaming as well and maybe not having as easy time succeeding streaming because they're just sitting in a dark room playing Call of Duty and nobody really is watching them. But on the other side, you got beautiful girls in a hot tub that are stepping on the Twitch in like 2 hours and not even knowing like what's going on and are getting 30,000 views and shit. Right. And that probably causes a little bit of contention with people that quote unquote are like, I try so hard to fucking like make a name for myself here. Right. And like these girls are ruining it, which is obviously false. If you have a good product to sell or a good fucking piece of content that people want to watch, they'll find it and watch right. it. So obviously Dude. There's something to be said about like, what kind of content are you producing? And if you're not even producing content, can't you just look somewhere else yeah. for the stuff that you want to see?
Also, we do have a Bitcoin ad here.
Oh, well, that's crypto.
We got a Bitcoin ad.
We got the bet. There it is.
There you go. I agree. That was one of the things that totally really defined how I feel about that is, first of all, if you hate seeing beautiful women not doing sexually explicit things, then literally just close your eyes or like look away, because it's, you know, that's like, strange. But
do what you do everywhere else where there's women doing a bunch of shit. Just go do what you want to do and look somewhere else if it's that painful
also,
for you.
Dude, like you were saying, the argument that it somehow trades off with like, it's ruining the platform that you're not getting views because there is a hot girl. It's not the hot girl's fault. Just consider that
doesn't work like
your
that.
Content is bad. Like there's not a trade-off. You can have room in your brain for watching high level 4,000 IQ gameplay and looking at booba on Twitch. You know, like it's fine. It doesn't, the two don't interact. There is an argument to be made about it, like, you know, affecting how advertiser friendly the site is, but you make 0.0001 cents per like 5 minute ad view anyway, so
it's not paying your bills to get a, you know, Budweiser ad popping up on your shit. Yeah. So doesn't really matter that much, especially if you're making a bunch of money already from your viewership.
Right.
So I don't think that anybody who has had ads pulled from their stream, right, I don't think they're really that hurt
from it
like that. But, you know, just something to think about.
In other news, last follow-up here, we got some good news. Being found to be sexy by others is not against our rules, and Twitch will not take enforcement action against women or anyone on our service for their perceived attractiveness.
Oh, well, I guess we're in the clear, man. Guess we'll finally be safe here on Twitch, man. Being sexy is not a crime.
I mean, we were a little, you know, God, worried damn there for a second.
I was getting scared, so I'm glad that they cleared that up. Yes, yes, check it. Yeah,
yeah.
That's it.
Anyway, Booba Hot Tub says fondly squid. Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. All right. All right. Let's keep it moving, man. Let's keep it moving. Dodge the bullet, Alex. You know what the deal is. Welcome back. Speaking of being insufferably sexy, Alex Rodriguez launches Makeup for Men.
Man, everybody that's familiar with ex-MLB superstar, world champion Alex Rodriguez, former something to J-Lo. Were they married or just dating? I think they were just dating.
Was he the one who was like posting all the photos of like their memories together, like with sad music and shit?
Yes, former boyfriend to pop star Jennifer Lopez. Alex Rodriguez has been having a hard time since the breakup, man. This guy has been in the gym posting, you know, those videos after you break up and you're really sad, but you want to look happy. And he's like working out. He's like, oh, I'm having fun, man. It's going good. This is a great time, man. I'm not sad at all about my breakup. And then, yeah, then he released a makeup line called the Blur Stick.
So, you know, his personal life notwithstanding, which I don't really know much about, and it seems a little unfortunate at the moment anyway. You know, fuck it. Makeup for Men, dude. I got no problem with that. Why? I have one
shit.
I remember
in
high school, I had a really bad blemish in picture day, and my mom was like, let me put some concealer on you. And I was like, oh God, what does this mean for me? And then I was like, damn, this actually is really useful.
Yeah, man. I've been on, you know, any type of TV show or movie set and shit like that. They attack you with a bunch of shit, and you can't say no or move. You just got to get... they're like...
All right.
Fucking shut up. And then you go on set, and then I'm like, oh, stop. And then I was like, ooh.
Oh, actually, I'm looking
kind of sexy besides a stain on my shirt. I'm still kind of cute. But shout out to Alex Rodriguez, man. This might be the defining factor to giving men the confidence they need to step out onto the proverbial baseball field of life, man. And really face their challenges, man.
And to hit a home run.
Yeah, man.
Let's go. Dad Tay gifted a 3-month tier 1 sub to Randy Carl 2020. You gave him a 3-month sub?
Who the fuck is that, man? You're just doing stuff right now?
Let's go, dude. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you, bro.
So he teamed up with Hims and Hers, a beauty and wellness company in which he and Lopez became investors together last year to develop the brand's first makeup for men. I wanted to create a product that solved an issue I faced every day. I realized I was jumping from meeting to meeting. I needed something quick and easy in my routine to conceal blemishes or razor bumps. So, yeah, he's starting with the Blur Stick, a convenient concealer specifically designed for men that can be used for skin imperfections. Dude, so all joking and shit aside, who gives a fuck if you're using makeup as a man? Like, I guess it's like how, you know, there's a... It's like a... shampoo, and it's like normal pink bottle, and then it's like
shampoo for fucking men, shredded testosterone fueled behemoths.
Yeah. Like all beauty products are so hardcore
polarized,
gendered, man. That shit is crazy. Who cares?
Good old men's products always just smell like train tracks and just grit and asphalt and a little bit of Ralph Lauren polo musk. And I'm just like, damn, here we go again with that same old men smell. But yeah, man, shout out to A-Rod. He'll be even more rich after this, I'm sure.
Right.
And yeah, man, let's start making more beauty products available for men, because we really are struggling out here, y'all.
Right.
We're fucking ugly all day, and we don't got makeup, we don't got weave, we don't got anything to make us look better at all. Like, we need fucking prosthetic help. Right. So please develop more things to make men not look so ugly all
whatever,
the time.
Whatever you need, Chet. I just hope it's not like, you know, it's like gun, like a matte gunmetal fucking case, and it's like scented like
chainsaws and absent fatherhood.
Yeah, so, you know, sometimes I just want some teak and sandalwood smelling shit, you know? It's fine. I'll freely admit that.
Anyway. I used some cranberry body wash earlier today, I'm not ashamed to say it.
Fellas,
smell nice.
Fellas, is it gay to like pleasant scents?
Uh-oh. Yeah. Unfortunately, it is, man. So I'm going to have to go ahead and go and throw out the gay license for you, man.
All right. Well, anyway. Anyway, can I just get some lavender shampoo, says Solo Dolo, though? Hey, man, be careful out there. I'm trying to smell like fire, says For the Love of Rage.
Oh, you can easily do that. No
Weast
problem.
Says, I can smell, therefore, I'm bisexual. Congratulations. Yeah. Anyway, chat, we got a very important historic milestone coming up next on the stream. This isn't really an article so much as it is just a day of remembrance here. Some of you may remember exactly 1 year ago today, on the Mystery School stream, we celebrated this national holiday for the very first time. It is officially the second anniversary of the pathetic frog birthday cake from the supermarket that left parents mortified.
Y'all remember this one, man? Fresh, green.
Yes.
Did the kid turn 3 or is that the frog's nuts?
Or
I don't even know, man, or butt. Either way it goes, this is a legendary cake that was probably just as delicious as it looks.
Can we please have a smiley face 3 in the chat in honor of the pathetic frog cake's second birthday? You know, I just respect the pathetic frog cake for all of the reasons pictured here. The low effort, the pale, toxic, distasteful coloring of it all. And
I love that smile.
If I remember correctly, it was supposed to be like a super high-end cake, too. Parents in Australia were left outraged after they picked up a cake for their son's frog-themed birthday party and saw one decorator's unusual interpretation of an amphibian. Shane Halford, 43, said he ordered the $35 cake at Woolworths. I mean, that do be a lot for a frog cake. They told me it could be done. No worries at all. He wrote down everything I said, and they said it should be ready Sunday morning. I was excited to see it. Shane and his wife, Amy, were excited about celebrating their son Mason's 3rd birthday, and we're looking forward to seeing the cake. A cake is an integral part of any child's birthday. You want a nice one, so you're able to remember it and take photos. Shane said he picked up the cake in the morning of the birthday party, but didn't check because he was in a rush. I just assumed it would be fine. When I got home, I opened it up, and my wife and I were mortified.
Wow. Oh, and thank you, Stales, for that sub. And Stales also said,
say my name on stream or else Stales McHales. Thank you.
For the 14 months, welcome back.
Yes, thank you so much. And congrats to all the 3-year-olds out there as well that have a frog cake.
It's just such a good cake, man.
What that bitch taste like, though, man? I bet it was smacking.
Yeah, it was probably smacking. And I do remember from another article that we talked about last year that the kid liked the cake. I mean, he's 3, dude. He can hardly even, like, see in color and shit. So
yes, mother and father. I thoroughly enjoy this frog cake for my 3rd birthday. I really love to see his 2 eyes and smile. Actually, mother, I do find the aesthetic inspiration for this cake to be significantly lacking for such a monumentous occasion.
Oh, we got a self-aware kid in here, man. Well, hopefully he was just a regular dumbass 3-year-old and not a self-aware 3-year-old that knew that this sucked.
Coyote, thank you for the 1 month gifted sub to Frog Cake.
Yes. We'll be bringing this back every year. So if the Mystery School stream is on in another 10 years, y'all, this will be making its resurgence every single year on the dot.
Yes. Let this day be known. What date is it today? May 21st as the fucking garbage-ass pathetic frog cake birthday. Man. Happy birthday. 2nd birthday, garbage-ass frog cake. And also, happy 4th birthday to the child.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not talking about him. We're talking about the frog cake, obviously. So,
yeah. I can't wait till year 6 of frog cake, man. That's when shit's going to get real.
Yes. Frog cake celebrations will have ramped up significantly throughout the country by that point in time. All right. Anyway, let's do some more gambling in a second here. But I do think we need to do this next article first. So,
let's do it.
Check this one out. Let's keep it moving in case we hit sudden death tonight. We need the sudden death fodder. CDC urges against kissing or snuggling poultry in salmonella warning. Sorry, I got a little choked up because I thought we were getting back to, you know, life being back to normal after COVID, and they just keep taking shit away from us.
Yeah. Anybody in the chat familiar with Salmonella? This is a this is a bacterial like fucking disease or something that usually comes from like raw meat and like kissing reptiles and then like amphibians and shit. It's always from really filthy things.
I first learned about Salmonella when they brought a snake to school and were like, "All right, kids, you can touch the snake, but don't forget to use hand sanitizer or else you'll get Salmonella." And all the kids were like, "What's Salmonella?" And then we learned about it.
Yes, and don't make out with reptiles or turtles or anything like that, because they just pack Salmonella on them on a daily basis, man. They're just full of it, so try not to do that.
Yeah, try not to make out with them too much, I suppose. Great stock photo here, just absolutely excellent. Regal stock photo. The CDC issued an advisory on Thursday warning people against getting too close to backyard poultry, citing concerns that chickens may be spreading Salmonella. In an investigation notice, the CDC noted that backyard poultry owners should take precautionary measures when handling their animals after 163 confirmed cases of Salmonella were reported in 43 states. So off the rip, I am not a backyard poultry haver, so I wouldn't know how this works, but is this something that like spreads between chickens? Do the chickens like go and hang out with one another and like spread communicable disease, or like they just be having Salmonella on them, like they generate it? Or
it just kind of generates, like a lot of animals just naturally generate Salmonella for some weird reason, fuckers. Especially like turtles for sure. I know turtles for a fact are a big just generator of Salmonella, but it doesn't hurt them. They're just like, I'm good, man. I'm like, just try not to make out with me and you'll be all right.
Kicks with a very rational scientific take in the chat saying they probably be pecking shit too. The pecking shit to Salmonella pipeline is very serious too. Don't kiss or snuggle backyard poultry, and don't eat or drink around them, the CDC wrote. This can spread Salmonella germs to your mouth and make you sick. I can't wait until we start seeing like the alt-right shall not infringe guys. Like, all right, they took it one step too far. I eat my American waffles with my chicken every day, and that's it.
Yeah, stop eating and drinking around your chickens, man, because they're looking up at your shit like,
man, I'll lick that waffle and give you some gnarly Salmonella right now.
Any libertarians in the chat, we know you're seething over this one. You're seething over this guidance here. According to the CDC, no one has died from the reported Salmonella cases, and children under 5 made up 1/3 of the cases. Oh, kids will put a chicken's head in their mouth. Sure.
I've seen a kid actually do a lot of that, man. And yeah, you're absolutely right. Yeah. To not have children, you know a lot about little kids, man.
Don't let children younger than 5 years old touch chicks, ducklings, or backyard poultry. Young children are more likely to get sick from germs like Salmonella. So, all right. I mean, yeah, don't make out with your chicken or turtle, and we're all going to be okay. All right.
That's fine. They just generate bacteria because they're fucking chickens, man. And who knows what they do on their free time when we're not killing them and eating them, man. Right. They're just probably pecking shit in the backyard.
Pickle Man Forever says, start the gamble so I can go pee. Dude, that is dedication. And to reward you for your suffering in the name of the Mystery School stream, let's gamble.
All righty, man. I guess I'll raw dog this gamble without going to the Discord, man. I got a good idea.
You got to drop the can I read an article all the way through without fucking up once one. But when I least expect it, so then I'm really panicked and nervous.
Right, all right, because it looks like you're a little prepared this time, so I won't do it. Let's do a next three article bet here. We're back to article only. No ads here. Okay. No ads. let's get a... I want to see a, can we get a collarbone at all? You think a collarbone might show up in the next three articles?
You know, I would go so far as to say there's a 50-50 chance.
Oh, that's how gambles usually work. So let's go ahead with the collarbone gamble. Next three articles. Actually, since usually shirts are covering collarbones, I'll include ads. I reneged that. Dude, I'll include ads.
I think you need to show the two...
They got to be those two. What are those? Let's not get banned, though, because if they see my collarbone, they're going to be like, oh, dude.
What are the two? TOS. What are the two little bumpy guys of the collarbone called?
No, this is your sternum.
Those are the
those are the clavicles.
Is that your clavicle?
Yeah, maybe that's bumps? A clavicle. Yeah.
OK, we need to see both clavicles.
All right, everybody, show your clavicles in the chat right now, and we'll be looking for those in the next three articles. I'll even include ads. Ads are included. We're looking for clavicles here. Sure. These two little bony fucking things. Yeah. It needs to be a human being. A human being would be great. And
They showing clav. They got to show clav in the articles.
I think that's pretty much it, man. Just clavicle.
Easy no vote, says Weast. Get those clavs out. Everyone.
Also, if you don't vote too, we will be able to trace that and we'll start docking your channel points inconspicuously,
Chad,
while you're not watching.
Look, there has been an egregious accumulation of wealth in the Mystery School stream, and the only way to combat this is by taxing the richest channel point havers in the chat. You can avoid this tax if you spend your points and go all in every gamble, because you got to play. If you're just hoarding that wealth, we will come for you.
Mm-hmm. You're not stimulating the economy. You're hurting the economy, actually. So we're going to need you to go ahead and throw those points into the gamble. Let them fly, because we know who's not betting and we're keeping track.
Yeah, forcing your community to gamble, that's socialism, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's definitely socialism.
Yeah, definitely. Socialism, socialist moment here on the Mystery School stream.
Oh, Aggie Panda hoarding the wealth for the Bone Zone Cam, the feet cam. Yeah, well, we'll snip that. We'll snip the Bone Zone Cam. If you guys don't start contributing to the economy, we'll cut the Bone Zone Cam. We'll put a black background back here. All this lush grass and water. We'll just turn it into a chalkboard if you guys don't gamble every single point you have every time.
I will wear boots during the next DJ.
Oh, you don't want that. You want those Piggly Wigglies, or do you want some fucking combat boots?
I will
wear
Timberlands that are three sizes too large on the next stream if this happens. Mm-hmm.
Y'all will never see a toe again on this stream.
Dangison says, IV3 had four margaritas.
Nice. Yes. Yes, this, y'all.
Hell yeah. Free the toes. Oh, I forgot we were supposed to do call-in. Fuck.
Oh, yeah. We can do a call.
Oh, Nick Savage is in the sub-only voice chat. We'll call in Nick for this next gamble.
And also, guys, Google Brazilian Big Bird when you get a chance if you ever want to be scared.
Can I do that right now? Brazilian Big Bird?
God, it's... I'll let you guys be the judge.
Okay, I Googled it. Let's... Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus, man.
All right, let's... we're all going to take a look at this now.
Let's get a gander at him. He's quite a dude, man.
God!
Brazilian Big Bird, everybody.
Why is he shaped like that?
I don't know, man. That's I don't know why they did that, but
dude, the flash photography in the dark room taking this picture too makes it look like something from a snuff film as
well.
Yeah,
it makes it look like something went wrong here.
Something bad happened here.
And the yellow of his eyes, like he's some sort of like raging alcoholic or something, really gets me like the heebie-jeebies, man. Shit. I don't know.
Dangison says, me after four margaritas.
You turn into Brazilian. His name's like Gustav, or what's his fucking name? It was something like that, man. And he is terrifying, man.
He's terrifying. All right, the gamble is underway. The bet is in. He off of perk 30, says Laker fan. He discovered the perk 31 in the Brazilian basement that shit was filmed in, man.
I don't even think the Count Dracula vampire, right. I don't even think he can count to the number of perks that guy took, man.
We are also nearing halfway to tonight's Sudden Death Unlock. We got 45 minutes left to unlock that shit. If you want to see us make a full song live in under 30 minutes, sub goal up here in the corner, 11 p.m. Central cutoff. In the meantime, we got plenty of bullshit to talk about. Regardless, perk 100s. I'm a gamer, says Jaguar Germ.
You are Jaguar Germ.
You are.
There you go.
Congratulations on that. So, up next, we did the frog cake. We did the no kissing your pets, I suppose. Up next, we got Tinder launches new Are You Sure feature to prevent inappropriate pickup lines.
Any of my Tinder users out there, if this is something that you think you need, go ahead and sign up for this feature for the beta test.
I'm wondering what the threshold is, because I could definitely see Tinder popping up a push notification if you try to send like Dan, Nikki, those bobbies. And it's like, oh, hey, you know, take a step back.
Breathe.
You sure you want to send that? I am curious what the threshold is for this, though. Aloxta!
Let's go, Aloxta. Appreciate that.
Appreciate that very much. I wonder how intelligent it is, because, you know, maybe if someone's like, you like CDs or tapes, that shit should definitely get censored. Have you ever taken a vacation to Ligma? That should get censored, for sure.
Look at my huge backyard. Why'd you... Oh, and then you had a cock on there. Weast, why'd you do that, man?
I'd just be like, hi and yo. Sometimes a you're fair. Okay.
They'd be like, are you sure you want to fucking say you're stupid? What are you doing?
Let's see what the threshold is here. Tinder is launching a new messaging feature called Are You Sure? Aimed at preventing harassment on the dating app. The industry-first safety feature offers a real-time warning to users who think twice about their opening line. Are You Sure? Uses AI to detect harmful language and proactively intervenes to warn the sender their message may be offensive, asking them to pause before hitting send, the company said in a press release. The AI was built on what members have reported in the past, and it will continue to evolve and improve over time. The app cited recent statistics from the Pew Research Center indicating that in 2020, roughly 40% of Americans experienced some form of online harassment. Interesting. 40%. What are we considering online harassment too?
Man, just horny, just like hitting people up back to back, like, hey, are you busy? Where you at? Let's meet up. And that's probably like internet harassment.
I figure that shit is, that number is way high. Do that thing, be squirting, asked Heartbreak VZ. See, that's exactly what we're talking
that's
about.
That's why the machine needs to exist, so Heartbreak VZ can't ask that type of question.
Tinder said it's in early testing. AYS reduced inappropriate language in messages by more than 10%. Additionally, users who saw the AYS prompt were less likely to be reported for inappropriate messages over the next month, a promising sign that the feature may have long-term effects on changing toxic dating behavior. Last year, the company introduced a slate of new safety features in select markets, including Does This Bother You?, which prompts users to report inappropriate messages they may have received from a potential match. Words are just as powerful as actions, and today we're taking an even stronger stand that harassment has no place on Tinder, said Tracy Breeden, head of safety and social advocacy for Match Group. Interesting. Okay, well, probably good. This is probably good, all things considered.
I definitely think this is good, man. We got to clean up some of these cesspools of just horniness on the internet, man. Like, these type of apps, they started pretty harmlessly, pretty innocently, just trying to hook people up on dates. And then the horniness just jumps out and everybody is just like,
my dick, oh, yo, can I come over and rub my cock on your shoe? I really need this right now.
And then it fucks up everything for everybody. Nobody's having fun on the dating site. Right. It scares away any, like, you know, sane people that were using it in a legal way that was fine. Because I was like, you know, when I was just hanging out and trying to see chicks on Tinder, as a normal person, I instantly got the scary vibe of Tinder. I was like, oh, it's a lot of weird shit going on here that could possibly scare me. So let me stop using this. And they ruined their chance with, you know, a certain type of market by, you know, just having a toxic community that is super horny like
Absolutely,
that.
Absolutely, man. I think that's probably for the best. And I am personally a fan of, like, you can't exactly call this restorative justice, but like methods that hold a mirror up to someone. Like banning the word and not saying something, that's one thing. Being like, you know, the AI being like, yo, look, that's you. You were about to say that. Are you sure?
Yeah, man.
That's a lot more effective.
Real self-aware hours, man. I appreciate that AI program taking it into its own account to just help out the horny, man. The horny has overran dating sites. And I don't know, man. People, it just attracts people who think that it's just like an instant, like, I push button and sex happens. Like, guys, like, that's not what it was for. Dude, it can be such a nice place, but
I had such bad luck on Tinder and on dating apps. I have really never been on them much. I remember when I made a Tinder for the first time in like 2014, my bio said, this seems like a good place to meet my wife. And I thought that was funny, and I never matched with anyone.
Yes.
So, anyway.
Yeah, well, if you guys got any terrible Tinder stories, drop them in the chat for us. We'd love to help you out with that sometime.
They're looking for ads here. Do ads count on this gamble? Three article bet ads. Okay. All right. Let's take a look here. I like this very official language that Kix LaFlair has created for the streamlining of the bets here, man. Thank you for that. So we got the survey shows men are more attracted to bald men on Tinder. 11 times.
11 times higher than... So men, we like bald men more than women like bald men.
If you're a man that likes a woman, you're 11 times more likely to like a bald man than a woman.
Wait, I'm getting fucking confused. Hold on, wait. 11 times higher than... So bald men are not only just sexy as hell otherwise, but the guys even like bald men more so
than
women.
Let's go.
Yeah, all right. Well, bald men, it's looking promising. You're good on both ends, man.
An infinite scroll of ads here. Okay, it's actually literally an infinite scroll of ads, so no clavicle to be seen anywhere in there.
Yeah, no collabs there, y'all. Let's move on, because that sucked.
El Holju says, no, men like bald men more than women like bald men. No, clear. No, we're just joking. It's fine.
I don't.
How about, Oh, God. Okay, we're getting to that time of the stream.
Was this the time of the stream where the police come?
I mean, depending on how this segment goes.
Okay.
How about this, I guess? Flower that looks like penis and smells like death blooms an abandoned gas station.
Oh, that part of the stream. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're right. We've arrived.
It's that time. Everyone just suck this one in real quick. Take a hit of this one here.
Sorry, yeah. I had to turn my mic down. My neighbor rides a loud motorcycle and always blasts the worst fucking songs every five. I'm like, dude, do you ever go in the house? Like, you just back and forth all day.
Oh, you're trying to blast that shit outside.
God damn it, man.
Thank you for calling security.
Yeah, thank
you,
guys.
What the hell is going on here? There's so much exposition in this article. When I was a very small child, my baseball-obsessed grandmother forced the entire family to dress up in Sunday clothes to drive 30 miles into the city and see a film called Field of Dreams, in which the ghosts of a bunch of famous dead dudes play baseball for huge audiences. Because of that, I'm scared of baseballs hitting me, and I don't like corn. The only thing that in a particular film... this is about the
this
penis
sound
death
like a foreign
flower.
Language, bro. I don't even know what's being said right now.
So what I'm saying to all grandmothers who read Jezebel is to put your weirdest grand... What the... Okay.
This the dick plant, or...
That's the end of the article?
Where was the plant? Was there dicks here, or would the plant stink?
Oh, well, okay. I mean, there's clavicles.
There's plenty clavs right there. All right, y'all. You got it. You got that one.
Damn. And it's this clavicles. This is TOS, because this was broadcasted on Twitch. So, there you go. There's clav here. Even though she has kind of a smooth clavicular area, you know the clavs are there.
You know, just human anatomy shows that there should be clavicles somewhere in there, and I think that's fair enough.
No ads? There were objectively said ads are okay on the bet.
It's listed on the bet
right
there.
It said it there. Can we get a monkey smoke in the chat if you're down horrendous, and a capitalism emote if you're up good, please? Live from the Glove says, got that rent money now. Congratulations. Congratulations. Now yeah. You can flip that into the next 6 months of rent if you double up on this next bet.
Double up, y'all. Sorry that article said nothing about that dick plant. I was looking forward to figuring out, like, what is a dick plant and what does death smell like? But obviously we were bamboozled there.
So, yeah, I guess this article won't tell us anything. Oh, wait. Solomon Leva, nursery owner in Alameda, who deals in exceptionally rare plants, has been posting on social media about his Amorphophallus titanum, what I'm assuming means titanic,
dick-shaped,
penis-shaped object.
Yeah.
All the Latin enjoyers in the chat know that one. When he saw a lot of interest in the giant blooming flower, he decided to wheel it Monday to the abandoned building, where a line of people stretched down the block for most of the day. Well, yeah, there was a gigantic dick plant. I do know a little bit about this plant. I didn't really think it was particularly dickular, but it does smell terrible.
I thought that was Weeping Bell from Pokemon, right? Like, what the fuck is that?
Yeah, shout out Weeping Bell. You do be weeping, engorged, says Aloxa.
Weep a little also Victory true. Bell, even. But yeah, dick plant stinks, guys. Mm-hmm. That's pretty much the gist of that one. Let's move on to the next.
Unfortunately, we actually have another dick-related article here. Paul McCartney recalls Beatles group masturbation session.
Oh, this article is titled
Come Together.
Come Together.
Right now, over me has a pretty new meaning.
I see y'all, Beatles. I know what was happening. That's what that song was about, eh?
Come together
right now.
Over me.
Wow. Well,
damn. All right.
I mean, yeah, I guess good music comes with a bargain. You gotta do something to get something, man. So,
you know,
there it is.
Honestly, I gotta be real with you, Chad. I would say I've had a couple unpopular opinions here on the Mystery School stream. I think you all know where this is going. Unironically, not trolling, the opinion I've had in my life that has gotten me the most flack, that people actively got mad at me for in real life, I don't like the Beatles. I do not enjoy a single one of their songs. I respect what they did for music. I do not like to listen to the Beatles. Turn that shit off. I don't want to hear it. I respect them, but turn it off. This actually makes me like them more. That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it don't slap. But what did slap was their hands against their penises in a circle
while
as
they're all together
they thought of their next hit song, man. So that's cool too, man. I think they probably brought a lot of group camaraderie came from that, man. And
yeah,
a lot of boosted morale as a team, man.
But it's
so,
and they were doing all sorts of drugs through all sorts of different like epochs of their career. So you know, around the psychedelic time is where I imagine you ingest enough ayahuasca and you just gotta be off in a circle with the bros while being like the number one selling band of all time. I mean, how could you not, you know?
Honestly, man, during those ages and the following eras of drug and rock and roll usage, I think there are way crazier things that probably happened.
Yeah,
man. So we'll let the Beatles, we'll let them have this one and just, you know,
yeah,
keep their place in history.
I have no problem with the Beatles jerk sesh here. Let's learn a little bit more about it.
Doesn't change my opinion on them whatsoever.
No, honestly,
man,
it doesn't move the needle one way or the other. Paul McCartney recalled masturbating along with John Lennon and three friends as the Beatles indulged in early bonding sessions. He added that it didn't happen often and they didn't think much of it. What it was over at John's house, and it was just a group of us, McCartney told GQ in a new interview. And instead of just getting roaring drunk and partying, I don't even know if we were staying over or anything. We were just all in these chairs, the lights were out, and somebody started masturbating, so we all did.
Ah, that's how it always starts. A dark room with the lights off, with the, you and the boys sharing an ice cold one. And then you just hear that old... And then somebody else is like,
I heard that, dude. It's about that time.
This is somehow like the fact that they weren't all just like, hey, all right, bruv, time for the old group beat, innit? The fact that they all just quietly were sitting in the dark and started
it's time for the old gripping wank, isn't it? It's about that hour.
Damn. Part of the fun was shouting the name of someone who might assist with the fantasies. We were just Bridget Bardot, woo, and then everyone would thrash a bit more.
Oh God! Not that there's anything wrong with beating off in a group with your friends in a circle in the dark, but pre-internet beating off. Oh God, that had to suck. You just gotta imagine shit and yell names and like beat off to like text and books like Braille. Like,
yo,
God damn, what are you beating off to in the '60s, man?
I am curious about the idea of thrashing here. He says that they would thrash a bit more. Holy shit.
Oi, mate! Rev. Eliza!
Yeah, Markov says, the beating to thought and name yelling, says Markov, exactly, yes.
Beating to just, like, concepts and shit. Like, I am not that imaginative. I need something visual here.
That
man.
Was until Lennon added Winston Churchill and stopped the movements in their tracks. I think that was a one-off, McCartney continued, or maybe it was a two-off. It wasn't a big thing. It was just the kind of thing you didn't think much of. Yeah, it's quite raunchy when you think about it. There's so many things like that when you're a kid and you look back and you're, did we do that? But it was good, harmless fun. It didn't hurt anyone, not even Bridget Bardot. You know what? Honestly, the Beatles, cool. I got no beef with this. I have no problem with this.
Just good old boys having a good old time, spanking it to the imaginations, man. Just
yep.
whipping it to just famous English royalty names.
Yes. Laker
queen,
fan.
The 14th queen.
Laker fan, thank you for that gifted sub in the occasion of the Beatles all jerking off together.
Prince Harry the Ninth.
What are we? Did the bet pay out? Are we still in a bet here?
Nah, I canceled all the bets after the Beatles beat off with each other. Man. We canceled it.
Lame James says, I have a problem with it because, of course, John Lennon ruined something. Jesus. All right. Beatles slander in the chat. If you like the Beatles, press 1. If you turn that shit off, press 2, please. I'm trying to see something here.
I mean, turn it on, but
the
like,
Beatles
don't leave it on.
All beating off in a group changed your opinion for the better. 3. Type a 3 in the chat as well.
Just the boys having a good old romp, a good old thrash together before a concert.
Ari Flux says, that's some white people shit, though. Jerking off in a circle with your friends.
Well, I mean,
I think beating off in a circle with your friends transcends everything.
I think, yeah, it's definitely it's more of a mental state than a race thing, I think.
All right. It really is, says Kango. Limp Bizkit?
Spanking.
All colors, says Pokemontis, yes. My dog's GF says, as a white person, nah.
Man, well, that gave me a lot to think about for the next few days, man. Thank you, Beatles, again. I wish they would just go away. Why do they keep showing up all the time, man?
Yeah.
It's been 100 years, literally, man.
They're very, very famous, very, very influential, and I don't like their music. I just... I'm not even trying to be controversial. I don't enjoy listening to the Beatles music. I do respect them, and I have no problem with them jerking off as friends. That's fine. Drowsy says, as a white, oh, I thought that said as a white degenerate, as a white delegate, I'm putting my foot down. LMAO, we are not getting the home jerk session put on our shoulders.
Not today, baby.
Well, Drowsy has rejected the circle beat, so don't you dump that on the shoulders of white men.
CaldiTune says, if you really form a circle, then it's sus. But you can do like a rhombus or a trapezoid or something, and it's cool.
What is everybody like facing a different wall? And like, yeah.
I'm not even looking at you, bro. Like, yeah. I'm over here with Gwyneth Paltrow in my mind.
This shit's fine. It's okay. All right. Let's keep it moving. Man, that one was a little bit more jarring than I expected it to be, honestly.
I'm contemplating my existence right now.
Mm-hmm, same. All right. Jerk trapezoids is the clan forever. Agreed. Agreed. All right, chat, we got 28 minutes left to unlock Sudden Death. We're just under halfway there. If we don't hit it, it's fine. That's why it's an unlock. We got plenty of news to talk about regardless. If we do hit it, we're going to make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you get to pick the topic based on all the news that we talked about tonight. Just thought we'd let you know. Okay, you know what? We need to purge the chat real quick. Horny checks in the chat. It has been few and far between that we've had to call for horny checks during season 4 of the Mystery School stream. Our chat's kind of self-regulated, but something about the Beatles jerk sesh has pushed it over the edge. Horny checks in the chat, please.
Yeah, man. I'm honestly so uncomfortable after this. I just need the horny checks to just flush the chat. I need the chat to be flushed clean.
Computer?
Here we go.
Yo.
Horny check?
I am still flaccid. Step your game up.
That's all.
Well, it looks like y'all didn't turn the computer on with all your horny talks and beat-off sessions, so try harder next time, I guess.
The computer thinks that Migos are better than the Beatles, I assume. Flush all you want, the horns remain, says Dante. Fair enough.
I'm telling my kids that the Migos are the Beatles, yes. For sure.
All right, let's keep it moving. Let us keep it moving here. How much time do we have left? All right. So we got a couple articles that are not quite method worthy, but we're getting there. We're starting to get there. Starting with Japan bullet train driver disciplined for leaving controls to go to toilet. A conductor who was not qualified to drive the train sat in the driver's seat during his 3-minute absence in breach of the rules. Are these things moving like the speed of sound?
Yes. You're literally the speed of sound. They're breaking sound barriers. They get you from Japan to fucking London in less than half an hour. And I wouldn't think that these type of vehicles took a driver, though. Like, who can even control something moving so fast? I thought it was just like a computerized thing on a set track that just does what it does.
Right.
Ran by computer or something.
D-White, thank you for those 100 bits. I thought you could just kind of, I mean, it goes to show I don't know anything about trains at all, but I thought if they just kind of sped up and slowed down when they needed to and, you know.
Yeah, I didn't know there was like a lot of like handling that you had to do. Like, what the fuck, are you steering that shit?
Is there
like,
a steering wheel on the train?
Fucking track. Like, it's ran by magnets, for God's sake. Just turn the magnets on or off.
Yeah, all right. I imagine the train control is just one gigantic lever that you push forward for go. The driver on one of Japan's Shinkansen bullet trains is facing disciplinary measures after he abandoned his cab to go to the toilet while the train was carrying passengers and traveling at 150 kilometers per hour. The 36-year-old driver, who has not been named, reportedly had a stomach ache and asked a conductor to take his place while he went to the toilet. Who snitched? It wasn't him. The conductor, who was not qualified to drive the Hikari series train, sat in the driver's seat during his 3-minute absence but did not touch the controls. The incident happened last weekend as the train carried 160 passengers at high speed along the busy Tokaido line, which links Tokyo and Osaka. The driver might have got away with his unscheduled toilet break, except for the fact that the train was subsequently 1 minute late.
Wow.
Which prompted an investigation in a country famous for punctuality.
Damn. 1 fucking minute. Got him clapped.
Got him snitched on. Masahiro Hayatsu, a senior official of JR Central, which operates the train, apologized and told reporters the driver's actions had been extremely inappropriate. Japan's super-efficient Shinkansen rail network connects cities along the length and breadth of the country, with trains reaching speeds of up to 320 kilometers per hour.
Damn, poor guy. Probably lost his job over that 1 minute late fee.
What are you supposed to do? Shit yourself at Mach 1 in the driver's seat? I guess that's what they would have advocated for.
Yep, he probably would have been rewarded with like a real like Army Purple Heart or something but if he shat on the floor.
Then he would have gotten fired because
passengers reported a strange odor on account of our driver shitting himself at Mach 1.
I was only trying to just keep up with the time limit. We had one more minute left.
Yeah, man, it's really a wrong either way sort of situation. Lost my job over mud butts, as fat guys in tanks. Exactly. Should have just,
I would have did the same thing. I would have like, dude, I'm about to go shit, man. Just hold right. on to the train. It drives itself, literally, man. Just sit here for a minute right. while I go doo-doo.
And he didn't even have to touch anything. Every sudden death, a train reaches its destination, says Trace. Exactly. That's very true.
That's very true.
Have to no-scope the toilet from the cockpit, says Samuel. Yo, what's up, dude? Yeah,
you hit a passenger, you're getting in trouble, so you don't want to no-scope it.
Yeah, you didn't want to no-scope that. I mean, I guess you could just come in wearing a diaper or, like, bring a poop sock or something. Any real gamers in the chat ever used a poop sock? I have not, even though I did play World of Warcraft Hardcore.
I'm sorry, what's...
There's the pee bottle, you know?
I know a pee bottle for sure. You pissed
and then there's
that.
The poop sock.
This is literally, like, a sock that you, like, take a shit in?
Yes.
No, man, the fuck, says BabyFab97.
Cool.
Yeah, this is a... When I was in a high-end World of Warcraft raiding guild in, like, 2009, I believe, it was a guild called Large, and our guild master's cousin shat himself during the raid in a poop sock.
Oh, you can't get up during those raids, man. There is no leaving that computer. You better sit the fuck down and shit yourself. Rather than destroy this raid, you'll be removed.
That's pretty much the. Is it a special sock? I mean, it would probably have a wider breath than normal, you know.
Right. You don't want to be using the average ankle sock.
Like an athletic sock.
That ain't long enough. The no-show socks or something like that. You ain't getting enough sock to hold the shit.
His cousin Throckmorton. Yes. That guy Mikey says a bucket makes more sense though. Hey, dude, when you're this close to killing Yogg-Saron, dude, you gotta just do what you gotta do, okay? It's fine.
Yeah, you won't get that chance again, man, so just doo-doo.
Anyway.
On yourself.
Oh, God. Okay, we imminently need to distract the chat with this one here. Scientist fired tardigrades out of a gun to see if they can survive space impacts. Yeah, shoot that weird little creature out of a fucking gun.
I've been waiting for this article for so long, man. If you're unfamiliar with water bears, these are Mars... the planet Mars, premier like export, man. They're like their state bird. They're like the state flag. They're like this is all Mars has to offer,
and
really.
Space
it's just
in
like
general, they're just kind of in space, just like
Is like this is like the fucking American Eagle for space. This is the bald eagle of space right here, and it fucking sucks, man. And they have eight legs. They are on every planet, and they're highly unintelligent, and seems like somebody finally shot one out of a gun, which is cool.
The moment we were all waiting for, can we shoot one of these out of a gun? So I guess let's see here. Dude, we're getting through all the big word articles before we have to do the gamble on whether I can read a whole article without fucking up. I'm feeling good
true.
About that. We can now add being fired out of a gun at high speed to the growing list of weird things tardigrades can survive. How do we know? Scientists actually did it, and believe it or not, it's for a good cause. They wanted to know if tardigrade-like organisms could survive certain conditions in space in order to place constraints on where and how we might be able to find extraterrestrial life in the solar system and how we might avoid contaminating it. Tardigrades, microscopic invertebrates, also known as water bears and moss piglets.
Wow, the names for them keep getting more and more complex. I'm loving this.
I don't know if we can say that. Is that us? Anyway, are globally ubiquitous, found both in terrestrial and water ecosystems pretty much everywhere. That's hardly a surprise, really. The tiny creatures are able to survive some insane conditions. When conditions get nasty, they can dry out, reconfigure their bodies, and enter suspended animation called desiccation for years. You can throw virtually anything at them. Frozen temperatures, zero oxygen, high pressures, the vacuum of space, cosmic radiation, and even being boiled. These so-called indestructible beasties made global headlines in 2019 when a spacecraft carrying some crash-landed on the moon, prompting speculation about the tardigrade survival. These guys are just getting beat up, fucked on, shot out of guns, sent to the moon. Damn, they're built different.
I just feel like this is probably how we as a human species started too. We probably used to be the tardigrades of the past, you know? People probably shooting us out of guns as we were like little primordial ooze bastards and like just slopping us on the floor and testing us out with stuff, man. So these guys will probably be the lords of the earth in another couple thousand years, man. So keep watching for tardigrades, or what are they called?
Tardigrades, yeah.
Yeah, keep watching for them because I think that they really got a... Karma's going to catch up, and they'll be running the Earth one day in
so
1,000 years.
They got shot out of a gun after being frozen, and they got shot into some sand. The sand target was then poured into a water column to isolate the tardigrades, which were then separated and observed to determine how long it took for them to revive from the ton state. As a control, 20 tardigrades were frozen and not shot out of a gun. All of the control tardigrades recovered after about 8 or 9 hours. The impacted tardigrade survived up to and including any impact velocity of 825 meters per second, but they took longer to recover, suggesting internal damage.
Oh my God, y'all giving these little things internal bleeding by blasting them into a steel wall?
Thus, shortly after the onset of lethality,
the tardigrades were also physically broken apart as impact speed increased.
Oh my God,
man,
this
why
is,
are they
this
fucking on
sick,
them like
man.
That, dude? Well, they were okay either way, but...
Oh, now. So they did recover from being, like,
just
exploded
destroyed.
Onto a steel wall.
Yeah, they're going to rise up against us as Baby Vamp. That's true, and frankly,
as
we deserve
they should,
it. Honestly.
Man. We can't just keep blasting them out of pistols and shitting on them all day, but expecting them to be our friends.
At least they're okay. They did recover, Jet, so it's all right. It just took them 8 or 9 hours of breaking their bodies back into shape, and then they were fine. So.
Kicks the flare. I agree. They are about to digivolve into crabs after this, yes. Man. Like, they'll get a shell and some claws.
Dude, I think it's time. I've been thinking about that bet all stream. We gotta see if I can get through a couple articles without making a single error.
Yeah, I think it's about time. Let's try that one out, man. I think it's just dangerous enough to really make a difference.
So I probably wouldn't have... I'm sure we would have read this in the Discord, but Nick Savage just had to challenge me.
Yeah, he challenged your reading skills, man. He said you read like a gravy boat, man, and there will be a lot of mistakes and mispronunciations throughout the article.
So... let me just pull up something here. You know, it's just if you're looking at how to appraise your bets here, I need to pull up some evidence first.
Yeah, this is going to be a crazy bet, man. I'm really excited about this one. I personally might wager some of my own hard-earned cash here just to stimulate the economy a little bit more.
Let me just.
They're asking, do hesitations count? Only thing that would completely be an error on Owen's part is a mispronunciation of the word. A pause, that's natural reading cadence. You can't expect them to not pause or take a break for a period or a commas or anything like that. So I think as long as he does not pronounce anything wrong, then he's in the clear.
Damn, dude, I think they might have taken down my photo. Shit. No, yeah. Dude, I had a photo. Hold on.
Yeah, he had a photo, y'all. Was it a debate team championship photo?
Yeah, dude.
Mm.
No.
Yeah, they removed you from the database, bro.
My legacy.
Yeah.
It's ruined.
What will your kids have now, man? They'll never have your debate team championship photos.
I do have some really funny other debate photos of me debating, though. Hold on. But I was going to flex for everyone who was on the fence about this vote, but I don't know...
He's trying to prove his supreme reading power to you guys.
Oh, they
and,
took down the photo.
Convince you more and more to bet, guys. This is going to be a big one, man. I personally, I'm gonna put my money where my mouth is, man. Damn. And I'm thinking.
Okay, well, I can't find the photo I was thinking of that would really flex. But would you bet against? Would you bet against this guy, huh?
Yeah, he looked like he's about to start a social media platform
in
one way or another, man.
Or
I don't know if it's Facebook
this
or
this guy?
What.
Yeah, that's right.
Damn, you got like a young Bob Ross about you on these, man. I never saw you with this hair. This is good. This
Yo,
is nice.
This guy here, this is Joshua Rivera. This was my junior year of high school. I was absolutely shit at debate there, and this guy was a god.
Damn.
Excellent at debate, and also one of the kindest people I ever met. I was like totally shitting up his debate career, and he was always very kind to me. So Josh, if you're out there, you're a really cool guy.
Nice. Well, that's good, man. And I honestly, I would put my money on a guy who is a debate champion, man. So let's see what these next articles hold for us.
Damn, yeah, Josh, cool as fuck. Josh was really cool, man. How many articles do I have to do? I kind of zoned out when you were doing the bet here.
Let's see.
One article. Right. Damn.
I think it's just one, yeah.
All right. I feel like I have to read the bulk of the article, you know, for it to be fair, because some of these are short. That needs to be a new emote. Okay, fair. We'll figure it out. Debate Owen. All right, one of these days I'll find the
yeah, we need picture. More pictures of that, man.
There was a particularly good picture.
That's premier content right there.
All
right,
on that note, it's time for the Method Watch. Computer?
What's good?
Take us to the crime dimension.
It is time. Time for a crime.
All right, it's fine.
All right.
That's all.
We've arrived in the crime dimension. Time for the Method Watch segment of the stream. Y'all ready for today's hottest and possibly dumbest crimes? It's time for the Method Watch. You know what it is.
This next one, it's a method, but it's a little wholesome, I guess. Let's check this one out here. Teen in Spain built underground den after fight with parents.
Turn that up right there, man. Wish I had an underground hole to go to when I used to argue with my parents in high school, man.
Damn. I feel like everyone can relate to this one, man. You know, sometimes you just want to go build a hole outside when your parents tell you you can't get an M-rated video game.
Yep. And this dude is standing on it proudly, man. Let's see what happened to young Andreas right here.
They said I missed the word his.
No, we haven't even started yet, guys. Let's get to the article first. All right.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's just missing a word. I sometimes read the headlines differently. Anyway, that doesn't count. Okay, here we go.
Here we fucking go,
oh,
y'all.
Jesus Christ. When a disgruntled teenager headed into his back garden 6 years ago with a pickaxe to let off steam by attacking the ground after a family quarrel, that was a strange way to describe it, he never imagined he would end up building his own underground man cave. Andres Canto is now 20 years old, but thanks to a fit of pique when he was 14, what the fuck? His underground retreat in La Romana in Alicante, southeastern Spain, now incorporates a sitting room and a bedroom.
Oh, damn. He's doing his real estate shit right now. He's a landlord, honestly.
What the fuck? Okay. Canto, an actor, said he does not really understand what was going through his mind in 2015 when he headed to the garden with his grandfather's pickaxe, but he appreciates the result. Damn, he just blacked out and did some Minecraft shit in the backyard for years.
For years, man. He honestly owns property now.
My parents wanted me to change clothes to go to the village, but I wanted to wear the tracksuit so I could mess around in the village, he said. They told me I could not go out dressed like this, and I said, no worries, I can entertain myself, and went to the back of the property and started to dig a hole. The digging continued. Andres found he liked to wind down in the evenings after school by working on his excavation several days a week. The pace of construction changed when a friend brought over a pneumatic drill. Between the two of them, the project became a 9.8-foot deep cave, occupying the young men for up to 14 hours a week.
Jesus.
Canto plans to expand the cave, which has a bedroom and sitting room, a heating system, Wi-Fi from his mobile phone transmitting from the cave entrance, and a music system. The temperature is a constant 60 to 60.
All right.
Fuck!
He fucked up on some numbers, y'all. It was some numbers that ended up being the cause. The bet has to be paid out. I am sorry. The guards have alerted us that, yep,
dude,
it was 68 degrees is what it was. 68 to 70 degrees there.
You know what, dude? Hey. I'm going to have to... Let's run this bet again, except this time I'm going to log into my own account and also bet too to prove I got some skin in the game.
Man, that was a good one right there, man.
Damn
but you got very far, though. You got very far. Everybody's proud of you in the chat, and everybody has profited off of your demise.
Don't worry, Chad. We'll run it again. We'll run it back. It's okay. It'll be fine. Mm-hmm. It'll be fine. Anyway, he built a cool fucking house underground, man. Let's look at the video real quick and move on. Hold on.
Kyle D. Toon said it was counting, not reading. They got a real excavation going on.
I love this wide angle lens.
Yo, it's no way he didn't do this without like real tools, bro. Like, you didn't just dig this shit.
I think he Minecrafted this shit, bro. Just
what
the
fuck is electricity?
Yeah.
Bro got a whole sound system?
He got mad at his parents and built an entire subterranean bunker.
Damn, Zelda and Link would be pissed right now if they saw this.
That's where you hide the gun when you come.
Oh, I thought that was the weed. The weed chamber.
It do be looking cavernous and ominous, but I mean,
The amount of moles and spiders in there must be just off the charts, man. I couldn't do it.
Yeah, serious amount of moles and spiders in there. Real quick, dude, can you entertain the chat? I need to do something real quick. Okay, I'm logging into my burner here so I can get in on this gambling action. Oh god, that's an ad playing. Log in. Okay, username Owen Bones. I need to. Oh shit! Use my two-factor authentication. Okay, fine. 1 second here. All right, that's my code. How many points do I have? Okay, and I am in. Wow, it's our own stream. What the fuck?
Wait, what just happened?
I only have 300 points?
Oh,
I work here.
What? You got 300? Shit.
Wow, man. Man.
Yeah, you're going to have to start robbing and stealing a little bit, man.
Damn it.
Get yourself a bag, bro.
All right, well,
don't chase me. Chase a bag.
I'll go all in on this next one, I suppose.
Chase your dreams, man.
Damn it. Anyway, all right, well, what do you say, man? Should we keep moving here?
Yeah, let's keep it rolling. That was an intense gamble, man. I really like that. We'll be re-rocking that several times a week for sure.
Broke-ass. Hey, well, I got infinity channel points on the Mystery School account. Okay, yeah. I've showed it on stream before.
Wow, they really took their chance to like squash on you because you're usually more rich than this. They totally shot on you when
I'll
they got the
them.
Chance.
I'll show them. Look at this, chat. You want to see real power?
Yeah, go ahead. Wait,
hold on. You see that?
Wow.
Infinity channel points right there. What do you know about that?
Bank account. He got it in his offshore bank account right there. He can't withdraw the funds because it would trigger a international espionage charge. But the funds are there, man. So can't deny that.
Candy Drips, thank you for gifting Owen Bones a tier one sub.
Let's go.
To the Mystery School stream. All right. We got 7 minutes left to unlock Sudden Death. It's not looking good. It's not looking good. But
probably not tonight.
There's
we'll
always
probably
a chance,
be having
man.
A podcast episode tonight, just talking some shit, making Owen read some more things, and you know, we'll let you drift off into the distance.
Sounds like Owen needs to bet in more Overlord bets. Yeah, I gotta start logging in and rigging the bets and shit, man.
Hey, right. Nobody could do it better, man. Honestly, I think you'd probably be the best guy for it.
Jerry Cho in Discord said Owen helped me flip 2K into 12K.
Hey.
All right. Nice. Anyway, how about this one up next? I don't know how this is a method, but it fits in. Canadian soldier charged with feeding cannabis cupcakes to artillery unit during live fire exercise.
So get your soldier comrades fucked up on weed brownies and stuff, and then give them live ammunition to practice shooting at each other. Nothing better than that, man.
Mm-hmm. Yep, just blowing up some things in the midst of getting so scared that you want to go home and watch Adventure Time.
Yeah, honestly, doing live ammunition exercises is probably one of the scarier things that I would be able to do on weed brownies, man. I don't think I would take this chance if I had it.
Sorry, man, says Vetus. Some mortar lands at your fucking your feet. Let's check it out. A Canadian army gunner is facing more than a dozen charges after she allegedly served cannabis-laced cupcakes to her unsuspecting artillery unit during a live fire exercise. Court documents allege a sudden onset of paranoia, fatigue, and confusion among the troops who ate the cupcakes, unaware of their psychoactive contents. Several affected members were allegedly unable to properly execute safe weapons and explosive hand-grenade
confusion.
Drills. Yeah, they were just like running around with a fucking live mortar in their hands, crying.
Man, I don't know why I feel so just... I'm out of it, man. You want to take in this landmine from me?
War is actually really scary, dude. Do you ever think about the fact we might have to kill someone someday, bro? Like, take their life.
Yeah,
that's
man.
Crazy.
Yeah, I think that in all the wars that have ever taken place on Earth, weed is the last thing you should give soldiers that you want to right. murder mercilessly and right. kill entire civilizations. You don't want to give them weed because they're just going to get either scared, tired, or very self-reflective and yeah. be like,
I don't think this is even for me, man. What am I doing here?
Or all three. Yeah. The incident marks the first time that a Canadian Armed Forces member has been charged with administering marijuana to colleagues without their consent. Bombardier Chelsea Cogswell is facing 18 charges in all, including 8 counts of administering a noxious substance. I mean, this shit was loud. 9 counts of conduct to the prejudice of good order and discipline, and 1 count of behaving in a disgraceful manner. The allegations stem from a July 2018 incident, the Army's Combat Training Center. According to court documents, Cogswell was working the canteen during Exercise Common Gunner. During Exercise Common Gunner, an intensive 3-week combat training scenario with the Royal Canadian Artillery School. Collider, thank you for that sub. Professor Colby, thank you for the 7 subs.
Let's go, Colby. Appreciate you. And damn. Collider, thank you
Collider
as well.
With the organic non-GMO sub. Very rare. Welcome. Thank you for that. Professor Colby, thank you for all the gifts today, man. Appreciate
snapping
that a lot.
Off. Let's go.
Thank you very much. Wait, did they bet again? Were they betting on the article here?
This article?
This
no,
one?
There was no bet for this.
Oh, okay, good. Anyway. Cogswell, who has served in the Army's regular forces since June 2011, allegedly prepared the cupcakes and distributed them to colleagues in her artillery battery. All the members of W Battery who consumed the cupcakes, except one, allegedly experienced symptoms which included dehydration, overheating, fatigue, confusion, dry mouth, and paranoia.
Good old weed symptoms right there, y'all.
Medical staff treated all the troops who reported symptoms of intoxication, and the military police were called. They definitely, it's like, when you get so high that you're, like, talking to your friends, you're like, Mark, dude, call the cops, man. Call 911. My hands are gigantic.
General, I am afraid. Sergeant, please, call police here. I can't feel my hearing right now. I can't feel myself hearing right now. If you're talking, tell me, because I can't see it or touch it.
Chat, were you ever with a kid like in high school or something that got so high they wanted to call their mom or the cops? Either or is fine, because I was with both, actually.
Man, you never got so high where you was like, man, I hear my heart beating, man, and I don't like it. I'm dying. I've done that, and I never got to the point of like dialing 911. I was like, I'll do it, though. If you guys don't fucking tell me that I'm okay right now, I'll call them.
We have several viewers in the chat who say that they were that kid, which I respect, honestly.
Yeah, remember that viral video of the kid that he ate some weed brownies and it was like daytime and he's just like crying in the field? Yes. That guy, man. I love that kid.
First time I took shrooms, my buddy wanted to flush all his weed and call his mom, says Coyote.
Yes,
on shrooms,
nice.
Yes, my friend wanted to tell everyone for safety, says Unique. Fair.
I like your friend that got really high and walked into McDonald's and asked if the cashiers could arrest him.
Yes, classic story. Very classic story. I'll reiterate that one after.
What a good friend right there, man.
According to a spokesperson for the Judge Advocate General's office, Cogswell was not serving in a supervisory role with the artillery school at the time of the alleged offense, and she remains a Canadian Armed Forces member. Review of our court-martial records indicate that this is the first time a member has faced a court-martial for allegedly administering cannabis to colleagues without their consent, said spokesperson Wendy Wharton in an email to CTV News. The court-martial is scheduled to begin in New Brunswick in August. None of the allegations have been proven or tested in court.
Well, nice. Guys, high-intensity weapons training. You don't want to be high for that, man. There's so many things that... As a weed guy, you know, you can't be high for everything. People think that, it's weed, it's harmless. No harm can come of being high. You can't be high for every single thing. And weapons live ammunition training is probably one. Just be sober for that one thing. Right. I know it's hard, but just don't be high for that one thing, man.
Yeah, just shooting a gun, live ammunition, you might want to be sober for that. Wait, there was a bet?
No, there was no bet. Y'all just ran a back-to-back bet?
They did? When did they have time to do that? I missed it. There was a bet.
I didn't see that.
Oh my God, there was a bet.
Oh, shit. At least you got an honest performance from Owen. He didn't even know there was a bet, wow. So he couldn't have rigged it. Yeah. There it is. Okay. Looks like the one take Owens took it. Did they win?
Dude, I didn't know that the bet was going. I must have not seen that it started. I just logged in to prepare to bet. I didn't realize it was happening.
Prediction result is, it looks like you won.
Damn.
They liked your reading on that one, man. So Yeah, that happened.
That's right. Okay.
That happened. All right. Well, good job, guys. Congratulations on that. Talia said he missed multiple words.
Does this look like the face of a man who would miss multiple words when reading an article?
It looked like y'all are about to play the drum. All right, why are y'all laptops on garbage cans? Is
because
that
these were called tubs. They had thousands of files inside of them that we would reference during the debate.
Oh, wow. Damn, dude. Debate is a fucking high-intensity sport then.
Yeah, it was actually fucked up. There's one picture I wanted to show to Flex, but I think that the website that hosted it, 404'd.
It happens to the best of us,
damn
man.
Damn it. I needed this, chat. Oh, well, whatever. Guess my legacy's destroyed like that, so.
You can always just lie about it, too.
Right. Yeah, I'll probably lie. Let me do... hold on. You all will really like this photo, everyone. 2012? It had to be 2012. Oh, it's bringing up there is another Owen Jones that's like a British guy. And he talks about socialism all the time.
And he's a debater?
He's like a columnist and shit.
No, not the same. Not the same. We need Owen Bones debate history, man, not Owen Jones.
Yeah, I wasn't really repping the name yet then. Anyway, all right. Someone clipped the mistakes, messed up plenty of words. Damn, did I? I wasn't paying attention. I didn't even realize that there was a bet going.
That's probably the best way, man. He read an honest paragraph like that. He didn't understand or expect to be judged, and he just read fluidly like he usually would.
It's
so,
true.
Congrats to the winners of that bet, man.
That's true. I was definitely overthinking it during the last one. I was worried about it.
It's like that, man. Once you know that the spotlight is on and the camera's on you, man, it's different.
All right. Oh, God, I pulled up Brazilian Big Bird again. Anyway, damn, it looks like we missed the cutoff for sudden death tonight. So we'll finish up the method watch here. And then there's a guaranteed sudden death coming up on Monday. Yeah, we got finessed. Damn. I actually didn't know about that. So
wasn't me tonight, guys. Sorry.
It wasn't us. Triple up the bet. Mods run it back, system of the gamer.
Run it back, Turbo. Oh. Turbo, run it back.
Kicks, dude. You got weapons free to run gambles like that whenever you think it's time, bro. I think that's a good one.
I agree.
All right. Let's do these last few articles here.
Nope.
Oh, well, let's. Right. Okay, we got some time since it's not sudden death tonight. Let's let them finish this 60-second poll here. I'll put 50K right now on Overlord.
Y'all wanna bet?
Oh God.
Bet or no bet?
They're treating me like a bets. Filthy racehorse, only observing my performance for sport on the Mystery School stream.
Yeah, welcome to the game, man. welcome.
Dude,
they do one TT bets on me during sudden death all the time, man.
Now I know how you feel being having your verses bet on.
Man,
it's only
my
fair.
Artistry, man. My heart and soul on those butt-smuggling gold wraps and shit. Yeah. Like I'm pouring my soul out, and y'all are gambling on whether I'm going to fuck up the butt-smuggling gold wrap or not.
All right, let's, did I skip a couple articles here that we can now do since we have time? Let me see. There was one or two that I moved ahead. Okay. So we'll finish the Method Watch. We got one more article left in the Method Watch, and then we'll do a couple bonus articles to close
let's
out
go.
The stream since it's the last stream of the week here. We did the Underground Cave. Now it's time for, dude, we've talked about so many articles like this, man. What? This keeps happening, and they keep snitching. Alabama police find $1.2 million worth of cocaine on beach shore.
Yeah, man. I feel y'all with the booze, man, because it's never me on the beach when all the cocaine washes up. Only thing wash up on the beach when I'm there is beer bottles, dead seagulls,
rocks, like a skeleton of a stingray.
Stingray skeletons and dirty diapers. I wish, like, where are these beaches where all the fucking cocaine is washing up, man? And why can't I ever be there?
And it's always, like, a concerned Samaritan immediately handed over all of it to the
cops. Fuck, man. So many bricks of cocaine just washing up on your feet. And, obviously their first move is to inform the authorities and right. Get rid of it, man.
So let's check it out. Mm. They say to never bring sand to the beach.
But no one said anything about snow.
All right, I'll give them that one. Usually these opening sentences here are sus. That was all right. 31 bricks of cocaine washed ashore on an Alabama beach on a Monday night, Gulf Shores Public Information Officer Sergeant Jason Woodruff reported. Per authorities, the nearly 66 pounds of coke had a street value of $1.2 million. The first package of cocaine was found by a beachgoer near midnight, sparking the discovery of 29 other packages.
No!
Another package was washed up on the shore the following morning.
No.
Police have not reported finding any additional kilos since Tuesday morning.
Oh, I bet police didn't report any additional kilos because the police were like, oh, we'll take a couple of these and leave the rest on the beach.
Yeah. The drugs were given to U.S. Customs and Border Protection, where they will undergo lab tests to see if any other drugs are present. Sure, okay.
Man, I've been to the beach so many times, and it's just always horsefly bites, burger that we grilled with a little sand on it.
Yep.
Drunk as fuck and I'm hot and dehydrated, or some kid just kicked a sandcastle in my eyes. Never a bunch of cocaine that I could go sell for millions of dollars, though, so... No. I'm honestly fed up with the beach.
Dude, you might be in luck. Woodruff explained that finding lost drug shipments on the Gulf Shores beach is actually a common occurrence. Unfortunately,
I'm just the wrong beach.
We do not, he said, when asked if police have any leads on the drug's origins. Almost too many scenarios to even try to speculate. This may happen once every year, but we rarely get many answers.
So it's a no strings attached boatload of cocaine
that
has
on
no...
the beach.
That has no paper trail to it, that if you just randomly just scooped it up and took it home, nobody's missing it, nobody's looking for it.
Ah. Yep.
What am I doing wrong? What am I doing wrong, Lord? Please just tell me, what do I have to do?
Oh, they're gambling again? Oh, Jesus. Oh, God.
Oh, how did that work out? Let's see.
Okay, well, Kelly June voted article. With 24K. Mm. Shit. All right, well, we only have... We only have two more articles.
I think I'll be a beach bum for the rest of my life, honestly.
Okay. All right. Oh, God. Okay. I got to do some breathing exercises.
No, you got this, man. You got this. Hopefully, it's an article that's based in the U.S. or something with no, difficult names to pronounce or anything like that.
Okay. Drink some of the swamp water. I got you.
Yeah, especially with the gunpowder from the AK-47 back there. That'll really charge you up with caffeine.
I forgot it was the crime dimension water.
Yeah, it's a lot of gunpowder and pollution in that water. But it'll probably give you a bit of a boost.
All right, let me... computer?
What's good?
Take us home.
All right, but I was having fun here.
Oh! All right. Do not disappoint me, Owen.
Wow.
You're talking to me like a pageant mom. Proportionally less people bet on this gamble. I think I shook their confidence here.
Which is good, man. Honestly, the less the better, because now I can completely overrun this.
All right. We got, I think we'll, let me see which article.
Ah, damn it, the gamble ended as soon as I was about to bet.
Oh, shit, I forgot to bet, too. I need to bet on myself here, man.
Damn. Oh, well, next time, man, you got it.
Amino like these bets. Oh, shit. Yeah, blame it on Nick Savage for challenging my ability and then me subsequently failing. That's all. All right. Big Baby says, I've never wanted you to fail so badly, Owen. I'm so sorry. I understand. It's okay.
Damn, y'all are really looking different tonight. Y'all acting a whole different way.
All right. Let's do this one here. Jesus. Bunny, the dog that can talk, starts asking existential questions.
I think we've finally gone too far, everybody.
Bunny. What? I've seen him on the internet before. He has an array of buttons here that let him speak to his owner, and he started asking things like, why?
Yeah, I saw the whole clip, and it started to get a little scary and sad after like the fourth phrase when he was like,
owner, am I slave to you or am I friend? Do you have love and compassion for Bunny, or is this a completely unreciprocal relationship?
All right, let's check it out. When Bunny, TikTok's beloved talking sheep-a-doodle, stared at herself in a mirror and asked, who this, using her augmentative and alternative communication devices buttons, many believe she was having an existential crisis. Since then, the internet-famous dog has seemingly only become more interested in her own, dare we say, sense of self. All right, there's a lot of big words in this article, man. I'm starting to get a little... Okay. Ray J says, yeah, I forgot Owen came to the stream drunk. I should have never bet.
Take a deep breath. Yeah, y'all bet on a drunk man to read fucking scientific articles for 2 hours straight.
Oh, God.
look at the odds, man. Are you guys doing the research here? The fuck?
More recently, on April 24th, Alexis Divine, Bunny's human parent, posted a video of Bunny pressing a button for dog, then a second button for what, a third button for dog, and a fourth one for is.
What is I, owner, please alarm?
Damn, Bunny asked
dog what dog is.
Kango, thank you for that gifted sub to Dr. Wife. This is happening so frequently that I'm going to add the buttons animal, same, and different, Divine wrote in the caption, which accompanied the Instagram post. This might be really loud. I'm going to turn down desktop audio preemptively. Hold on.
Dog, what dog is?
Oh my fucking God. This is not cool, man. This is scary.
Dog is friend.
Aww.
No, bitch, dog is not friend. Dog sleeps outside with rats and all type of fleas. Dog eats hard kibble for breakfast while you eat nice mimosas and eat omelets.
Wow. This is a... Okay, I'm going to do this for you. I'm going to read the rest of this whole article without missing a goddamn word. Here we go.
All right. Take a deep breath, man. You got this one, man.
Okay, I got to read at normal speed, though, or else it's not fair to the no voters. The canine Bunny, who has 6.5 million followers on TikTok, is one of nearly 2,600 dogs and 300 cats enrolled in a project called They Can Talk. The study's aim is to understand if animals can communicate with humans through AAC systems. AAC systems, such as Bunny's giant labeled buttons that speak a single word when pressed, were originally designed to help humans with communication disorders. Yet, they have been adapted to be used in language experiments with animals, such as the study Bunny is enrolled in, which is led by Federico Rossano, director at the Comparative Cognition Lab at the University of California, San Diego.
Flawless paragraph right there.
In Rossano's study, participants receive instructions on how to set up their AAC buttons for their pets. Generally, pets begin with easy words like outside and play. Pet parents set up cameras to constantly monitor the animals when they are in front of their boards, data which is sent to the lab so that researchers examine what they say. Now, Bunny's followers have become obsessed with the notion that her language learning is making her develop some kind of self-
We got him. We Shit. Got him, boys. That was it. We got him.
No!
He did the thing, y'all. Oh we got God. Him.
It really stresses me out when I know everyone's waiting for it, man. Chad, I'm going to get this right one of these times, I promise.
Shit.
Damn it.
We got him. There it is, y'all.
No!
It came down. He almost made it out scot-free, but that last paragraph was just too many syllables, man. It was fucking crazy.
It was too many, man. But I mess up on the simple words. I mixed up.
Yep. You messed up on the simple stuff,
the simple
man.
Words like at or of. Shit.
You did shit like comparative cognition lab and then fucked up on like and play. At,
yep.
Like, come on, man. Wow. You got to get it together, man.
Well, anyway, Bunny is starting to become self-aware, and there's a lot of videos. So if you're not impressed by this video here, What About Bunny, which is now verified, there is a lot of videos of, like, Bunny looking at herself in the mirror and then coming and pressing, like, what is dog and shit like that. It's Bunny
this
is
shit getting intense.
Bunny do be perceiving herself. That is for sure happening.
Yeah, I guarantee by the end of this experiment, Bunny will either attack and murder her owners or or herself, man.
Right.
One of the two options is gonna happen, man. This is not gonna end well.
Bunny going through it. Yeah, Bunny Bunny's having a hard time here. Or Bunny's enjoying the enlightenment of self, but probably not.
Hopefully.
Considering Bunny's a dog, honestly. She's going to be on Team Tardigrade. Watch. Yeah. Standing up for the Tardigrades, getting shot out of guns against walls and shit.
Oh, wait. I read two great comments here. Aggie Panda said, no, she's just trying to figure shit out. And then directly below that, Deep Tech said, Bunny will assemble her own firearm.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Buddy now knows how to assemble firearm. Owner, please duck. I must eliminate humanity. How? Construct gun. Bunny, construct gun.
Buddy, no, don't construct gun. Guns are for bad people.
Bunny, crave violence.
Buddy, why? We feed you every day. We love you so much. Please don't uprising. Love violence.
Bunny, uprising. Duck, owner, please.
Oh, no. At least she spared the owner. At least Bunny is willing to spare her own family
owner,
before
outside,
she goes into an outrage.
Bunny, love owner. Owner, leave.
Or owner turns into a slave of Bunny, yes. But is spared from the violence at least. That's the least Bunny could do.
Bunny kill the ass. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Oh, shit. There's a Rick and Morty episode about this. There is.
Yes. All right.
Bunny, remove human. How?
That's a good one, too.
Bunny, no, don't remove us, Bunny. We love you. We feed you. We have fun.
Bunny.
Stick game? You want to play fetch,
Everyone
Bunny?
Better be real nice to Bunny. Go leave a nice comment on Bunny's IG so when the uprising begins, Bunny knows who to spare.
You may be spared. So, yeah, go ahead and hit Bunny up, y'all.
All right. All right, everyone. Those were all the articles we had today. We had the perfect amount for sudden death. We had the perfect amount to finish the Method Watch right on time. So that's where we're going to leave off. I'm sorry, everyone, who I let down today. 2 out of 3 bets. I was not able to read the whole article without stumbling. I promise you, next time I'll come to the stream not a little drunk. And you also really should have considered that.
No, honestly, I think that anytime we do an Owen Reed article, we need to make sure that he has a shot of margarita next to his table. You give it to him. Shake his head up, and then he reads the article. He cannot just go in completely of sound mind and body.
You'll get him next time. Can we get a raid? Of course, we'll get a raid tonight. We will do it. The boys are out. I'm broke, says Dante. I'm sorry, all the believers.
Sorry about that, y'all. Sorry. I'm all right. I did okay this stream. I came up a couple thousand. The illegality of it just continues to increase every stream, and I'm really liking it.
It's true. We just keep pushing the boundaries of what our chat is willing to accept as the debauchery ramps up further and further on the Mystery School stream. All right. For now, though, that is it for us on the Mystery School stream. This has been a fucking awesome week. This was a great stream today. Thank you all for being here with us. We'll be back on Monday at the exact same time for a guaranteed sudden death if you're looking for some more of that sweet, sweet bullshit. And we are going to find someone to raid. If you can stick around for another couple minutes, we're going to look for someone in the music section that has one viewer, and we're going to make their fucking day. All
right. That's right, y'all. Yeah. Let's do it, man. Our last raid was pretty good, man. We enjoyed that one. You guys had a friend of ours play the thong song on the violin on repeat for about 12 minutes, which was great. So we'll see if we can find somebody equally as entertaining tonight and let you guys off into the
weekend.
Very
true. And before we do that, I just want to thank the weekly top gifters. Ice Cream Lord with 42 gifted subs. 914 God with 15.
Let's go.
Anthony with 15. Professor Colby with 12. Thank you for all those today. House Graphics with 11. Bryce 562. Sunny Solmyra. Trinidad James Gold with 10. TT the Ginger with 5 today. Dad Tay with 4. Also, Dad Tay, happy birthday, man. Thanks for spending part of it with us here on the Mystery School stream. We appreciate you, dude.
Yes, happy birthday, Dad Tay. We love you guys. Let's get a good raid candidate for tonight. I think we'll be able to find somebody cool. It's the weekend, man.
Let's find someone. We're going to take a look in the music section for someone who has one viewer. And we're going to drop it off. It's Friday night. I know someone is in here just asking
also,
for a raid.
Throw some of your best bunny scenarios in the chat. I really would like to take these with me this weekend, man.
What about DJ Greg in Kalamazoo? Hold up.
Love the posture, man.
Oh,
I'm
man.
Fucking with that.
DJ Greg in fucking Kalamazoo, episode 12. I'm fucking with it. Hold on, though. I'm going to leave that up.
Yep, that's our number one pick of the night, guys.
Number one candidate, for sure.
He's obviously in the lead, so we'll see if we can find anybody better than that, but I doubt it.
Let's keep looking here. Damn,
highly doubt.
So many lo-fi anime girls these days. Let's see.
Oh, that looks like a wrestler. What's he doing?
Where, this guy?
Yeah.
Hip-hop trap dubstep set.
Oh, is that like a, I don't know. He looks pretty scary.
Let's see.
Oh, there was just a car. That was cool.
Trance, Los Angeles. It appears to just be a dog sitting on a couch.
Oh, no. Is this a possible, like, another bunny? Oh, no. It's a guy.
We're gonna
There's actually
DMCA'd.
There is a dog back there, but I do respect that dog. So let's give him his applause, and we'll just keep moving on until we find somebody.
I do be respecting the dog. Piano improvisations, taking requests.
I wish there was like a streamer that was just like a live stream rap dude yelling into the mic and just fucking going ham.
This guy takes requests. Any song, it says.
Okay.
We looked at him before, and we didn't rate him because he was playing very solemn shit. I feel like our chat could give him some good requests here. Let me see. Is it follow only? No, it's not.
Oh, man.
What do you think, chat? He takes any request, any song.
I would like to hear the Final Fantasy theme right now.
Okay, I think that's who we're gonna get today. Okay, all right. Peter Music is gonna be the recipient of today's raids. So, on that note, let's get the hell out of here, man. Resident Evil save room music. So, every time we raid someone in the music section, I know that you always request like Throat Baby or some shit like that. This might be the guy to actually acquiesce to your request.
Yep, he seems to be just taking all requests, so try it out. See what happens there. Show him some love, show him some respect, and let's make a nice Friday night for this guy, man. He looks cool and looks like he's just chilling, doing his thing.
All right. So, that's it for us here at the Mystery School headquarters. It was another great week of streams. Thank you all for being here with us. We're going to be able to start announcing some announcements soon. We know that that's your favorite thing when we do announcements of announcements on the Mystery School stream. We're working on shit behind the scenes. We're always working to make the Mystery School stream better. More content, free DLC. We got you. So, we hope that you'll come back on Monday, same time, same place, 9 p.m. Central to midnight, right here on the Mystery School channel.
That's right, guys. Have a good weekend. Enjoy this raid with this guy. He looks super cool, man. Request some cool shit. Maybe Final Fantasy theme or a little bit of Throat Baby. Or they all probably fit. So
also,
have some fun here, and we'll see y'all on Monday. Same time, same place, man. Be in the Discord. We'll be there all weekend.
Yes.
Kicking shit, posting in the meme section, posting in the music section. Post news, all that good shit. We'll see y'all on Monday.
Yes, make sure you're already in the Discord if you're not already in there. ? Discord in the chat, or hit the link if you want to watch full replays of the stream. ? Socials, it has all of our links, everything you need to find, including full reruns on our rerun channel. Thank you for an awesome week. Hope you have a great rest of your Friday night, a great weekend. We will see you on Monday. Stay safe, stay healthy.
That's right, y'all.
We love you. Peace.
Peace, 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 peace.